Gentleman's Game here. Today we're going to talk about one of the most likely things you're doing that's keeping you a virgin. But first, just a heads up that for the next 48 hours only, I'll be giving free one-on-one consultations with either me or a member of my team. Yup, to anyone. All you have to do is click in the link in the description box below, so talk soon. So lately I've been exercising more often with my boy Randy. We typically go to the gym around the same time at night, so it tends to be the same people that we see there. And there's this one girl that we always see, let's call her Zoe, that Randy totally has a crush on. One time he noticed her working out by herself and told me, "Oh, dude, there she is. Damn, her body is so nice. I need to like talk to her, dude." And I start hyping him up like, "Dude, just go up to her and ask if you can work in with her. You've been checking her out for like weeks." I could tell he was nervous, which is totally normal, but after some more nudging, I finally got him to go up to her. I observed them from a distance and kind of see how she responds, so that I could give him my honest perspective on his chances with her, like any guy should do for his boy. He goes up to her, says something, she laughs. "Oh sweet, it's going pretty good," I think to myself. They talk for like 5 minutes, and as far as I can tell, she's totally giving him good vibes and indicators of interest. She's like laughing, holding eye contact with him, etc. Then he walks back to me. "Dude, I think she likes you. Did you get her number?" "Huh? Oh, nah, I didn't." "Well, why not?" "Just thought it might have been a bit weird." "Well, she clearly looked like she wasn't bothered talking to you." "Yeah, it was good. I asked her what she was working out and she said legs, and we started talking about working out a little bit. She even complimented my arms and said they were big." "Okay, so wait, why'd you come back here then without getting her number?" I don't know. I just told her I was gonna finish my workout and then I left." "Wait, so let me get this straight. You've been crushing on this girl for months. You've been slowly building up the courage to go up and talk to her. And then when you finally pull the trigger, it goes well. And then you walk away?" I was very frustrated for my friend. I felt like he had wasted an amazing opportunity. And the thing is, what he did, i.e. self-ejecting from a conversation that was going really well, is extremely common. It's something that a lot of my students have admitted doing when they talk to a girl they like. Thankfully, I didn't have to think too hard as to why guys shoot themselves in the foot like this. Because truth is, it's something I used to do in my early 20s when I hadn't yet developed confidence and understanding of how to talk to and attract girls. So allow me to enlighten those of you who have done this before. See, when a guy lacks true confidence or feels nervous, he'll tend to self-eject from an interaction before he needs to, especially if that interaction is going well. Why? Because he's not really talking to her with the goal of getting her number or taking her out and seducing her. He's talking to her with the goal of not screwing up, of not saying something stupid that'll make her think he's weird. In other words, he's not playing the game to win. He's playing the game to not lose. He's more concerned with quickly gaining some validation from her than he is about actually furthering his chances of dating and seducing her. Like he's thinking, "Oh sweet, I can't believe I'm actually talking to her, and she's actually responding well. Man, I wasn't prepared for this, to be honest. You know what, let me just exit the conversation now before I slip up and say something dumb and end this on a high note." It's like that quote, "Our greatest fear isn't that we are inadequate. Our greatest fear is that we're powerful beyond all measure." Most of us just assume that we're gonna fail so that we don't get disappointed. Then when we finally do taste success, we don't know how to handle it, to the point where the idea of winning becomes scary. I told Randy all of this that night after the gym, and I made him promise that the next time he saw her, he'd go up and talk to her again. But this time, to make the decision that he's gonna actually try to take things further with her if he sees that things are going well. And that's exactly what he did the following weekend when we bumped into her again. This time he actually played the game with the goal of winning, and approached her warmly, with much more confident body language, knowing that she already received him well last time. And again, the convo went well. They ended up talking for so long that I just finished the rest of my workout and left myself. He told me later that night that he got her number and that they were planning on working out together the next time. Awesome. So the big thing I want you guys to take away from this video is to be aware of it the next time you find yourself self-sabotaging your chances with a girl by prematurely self-ejecting from a set while things are going well between you two. You have to seize these opportunities, since you'll only receive so many. Randy did, and he and Zoe are now actually dating after a couple months of working out together, and eventually on some real dates. So that's it for today's video, just a quick lesson about preventing self-sabotage that I wanted to get out there for you guys who can relate to what I'm talking about. As always, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my new videos. I'm always dropping heat on the weekly. Stay tuned. Peace.